Hello everybody, I welcome you to the eShikshana program. So today's this lecture is for the BYAC students third semester for the subject climatology with subject code 18 ERC 3.3. So today's lecture is mainly about classification and characteristics of tropical climate. In previous lecture we studied about what are the different elements of different climates, different climatic zones. And today we'll be studying in detail about what are the actual characteristics of these particular climates and the classification of tropical climate. So firstly, I would like to introduce about the world climatic zones before going into detail about the tropical characteristics of tropical climate. Okay. The world climatic zones it is a classification that was done by Dr. Valmer Köppen. It is also called as Köppen classification of climate. So this climatic classification was devised in the year 1980 based on average annual air temperature and total annual precipitation data for the areas around the world. It means this classification was done majorly considering three aspects, or you can say two aspects, that is mainly temperature and precipitation. Temperature, that is the hotness or coldness of a particular region, and also when we say precipitation, it is it might be in different forms when we studied the previous lecture. So it can be either the formation of dew, the formation of mist, fog, rainfall, hailstones, or any other form of condensation of water. So based on these two elements, the classification was done for the world climatic zones. Okay. So based on this, the classification was again classified into mainly different categories, and they had types and subtypes, or you can say groups and subgroups. Okay, so the major classification you can say is done for a tropical rainy climate, dry climates, mild humid climates, snowy forest climates, and polar climates. And the letter A indicates the capital letter A indicates tropical rainy climate, the capital B indicates for dry climates, and the capital C for mild humid climates, capital D for snowy forest climates, E for polar climates. Okay, so yeah, we can see the further classification. So that is again subgroups that are only for the B climates. B are nothing but, again you can see, so they are only dry climates. Okay, so there was a classification that was done only for the dry B climates. That is, there are two types, again subgroups you can say, that is semi arid and arid. Okay, so we'll study in detail about what are the characteristics of the semi arid or arid. So similarly, for the letters that are representing tropical, temperate, and other cold climates, so there is again a sub group that is for dry season in winter, and S stands for dry season in summer. Okay, and M stands for monsoon, or with you can say with more precipitation. Okay, or it can say rainforest climate. Okay, so this was again the further subgroup that was W, S, and M, that was done for mainly A major groups, that is A, C, and D. Okay, so the A is, again we say it is tropical. Yes, A is tropical, C is humid, and D is snowy and for forest climates. For B, we have already studied, for the dry climates it is only semi-arid and arid. Okay, so there are again classifications. So this was mainly done to so that we can classify into maximum number of types, so that we give a precise characteristics or a precise terminology for that particular climatic zone. Okay, now third letter denote the further variations in the climate, the further changes. So you can say A is hot summer. So hot summer, which is exceeding, let's say, 22 degrees Celsius, that is for C and D climates. Okay, and B is warm summer, that is less than 22 degrees Celsius, and it is also for C and D climates. C is cool and short summer, that is less than 4 months with the temperatures with less than, more than 10 degrees Celsius, that is also for C and D climates. Okay. And D is very cold winters with less than minus 38 degrees Celsius, or you can say approximately up to minus 38 degrees Celsius, that is during the coldest month. Okay. And H is for hot dry, that is more than 18 degrees Celsius for B climates only, and K is also for dry cold. Okay, so it is H is for hot and dry, K is for dry and cold. Okay, so again the temperature should be less than 18 degrees Celsius for the climate to be classified in this category. Okay. So with the combination of all these the major classifications, the subgroups or the subtypes, so we can exactly define what kind of that particular climate. Suppose if you are trying to say AF denotes wet equatorial tropical rainforest with rainfall of driest month, which is less than 6 centimeter, or we can say 600 mm. Okay. More than 600 mm. Okay. So that is again a tropical rainforest which is having very good rainfall, but again it is a tropical climate. A is a classification for tropical climates. Now all these that is AF, AM, AW and CWA are majorly for the tropical climates. So we can see a monsoon trade winds, rainfall or driest month. So that is again based on the M, that represents the monsoon characteristics. Okay. And similarly, W represents a wet, dry, tropical, 1 month with less the precipitation, which is less than, 6 centimeter. If it is more than 6 centimeter, it is considered as wet, tropical. If it is less than 6 centimeter, it is considered as wet, dry, tropical. Okay. So these are the classifications that is mainly for the major category of tropical climate, that is A. And similarly, there is the classification for B in terms of SH. HS represents again steppy, and W represents arid. Okay, there is again further, you can also classify in terms of dry subtropical 25 to 33 degrees north or south. Okay, so they are mainly basically deserts. So this classification we'll also be studying in detail. For the A, B and C type of classification, we'll be studying in detail with the help of elements. Okay. So similarly, the Köppen classifications also consist for the climate that is mostly subtropical, that is for mild humid climate, and also that is represented by CFA and CSA, CSP stands for Mediterranean mild humid climate with dry or warm hot, that is summer. Okay. And CFB and CFC, marine west coast year round precipitation, that is rainfall throughout the year, and greatest is during the winter months. Okay. So similarly, for the cold climates, there is a classification based on the rainfall, and this classification, as I explained earlier, it is only based on the type of precipitation during winters, precipitation during summers, and also the kind of temperature variations that happen in the atmosphere. Okay, so these classification are based only on these categories. Okay, so similarly, it is again further classified DFA, DFB representing moist continental snowy forests. So this D stands for again cold climates, and again further it can also be see that E stands for polar climates that are very cold, so the temperature where it goes less than 0 degrees Celsius, and if it is having slightly lower temperature, then you can say it is considered as EF, that is, and if it is having slightly more, that is temperature, if it is more than 10 degrees Celsius, it is considered as ET. Okay. So these are the Köppen classifications that is mainly for the world classification. Okay. So this is again a table that is representing the same. So A is nothing but tropical, humid. Here we can see the different again subdivisions of and represented by AF, AM and AY. Okay, so this is again showing the tropical wet. Okay, so tropical wet, tropical monsoon and tropical savanna. Okay, so this is again subdivided or sub classification. Even dry climates are again classified into subtropical, subtropical steppe, mid latitude and mid latitude steppe. Okay, and further you can see the cold climates, that is again subtropical climates, are further classified based on the precipitation and humidity. So this is a classification and also the indication for that particular climatic zone. So this is for the cold climate, very cold climate, that is D stands for severe and mild mid latitude climates, and E stands for, let's say, polar. Okay, polar climates are again classified only in two types, that is tundra and ice cap. Okay, so based on this you can see in the map the Köppen's classification. So A, B and C represents tropical, dry and temperate respectively. We can see that major part of the earth, the landmass is having this particular climate, that is either tropical, B dry or C temperate. Okay. The cold and polar climates are towards the northern hemisphere or towards the southern hemisphere. That is, you can say Greenland, yeah, northern Russia or Canada. But whereas other countries, all other countries, even India falls into the tropical and dry or temperate climates. Okay, so there are, so we need to study this classification in detail to understand what are the major climatic classifications throughout the world, and also what are the major classifications of India we'll be studying in detail. So firstly we are going to study what are the classification of tropical climates in detail with respect to the let's say elements of climate. Okay, so tropical climates, as we can see, there are mainly three basically tropical climates. So that is again sub classified as warm, humid, equatorial climate, hot, dry, desert climate, and composite or monsoon climate. Okay, so there are also two categories in each. Warm, humid, equatorial climate can also have a subgroup of warm, humid, island climate or trade wind climate. Okay, so this is again a subgroup for warm, humid, equatorial climate. For hot, dry, or it can also be classified into another group, that is semi-desert. Okay, so it can be hot, dry, which is very dry, or it can have slightly more humidity because of the maritime, that is the sea or water bodies. So that can be again classified into hot, dry, desert or semi-desert climate. Okay, so this is also one of the classification. So composite or monsoon climate, so this climate is very interesting. It might be combination of warm, humid, and it can be combination of hot, dry, desert. Okay, so these might be again seasonal variations. It might be having extreme warm, humid behavior, or it can be having very hot, dry behavior in a particular, in every year. Okay, so it might be exhibiting these qualities or these characteristics, so that is why it is considered as composite. Okay, so then building has to be designed based on the extremes of that particular climatic zone. Okay, so it is very clear that basically we can consider three climatic classifications, and each climate is again subdivided into, let's say, two classifications. Okay, so firstly, starting with the warm humid climate. Warm humid climates are found in the belt near the equator, you can say 15 degrees to the north and south. Okay, so where there is highest you can say solar radiation that is absorbed, and also it is very hot. Okay, for the major part of the year. Okay, so that is why it is considered as warm. And since it is also humid, we can see that based on the elements, so this is again the elements and what are the values. So that is the data, climatic data for that particular climatic zone. Okay, so we can see air temperature, diaphragm temperature is maximum, that is 27 and 32. Now 32 is the maximum temperature for, let's say, during summer, and 27 degrees Celsius is the maximum temperature for winter. So this is the range that the temperature. So we can see it is always in between. The highest maximum temperature is between 27 to 32 degrees Celsius. And mean minimum, that is the least temperature recorded, can be around 21 degrees Celsius at night. Okay. So we can see there is not much temperature variations. that is hardly 11 degrees from 21 to 32 degrees Celsius. So there is only 11 degrees variations. So it is usually warm throughout the year. Okay, even during night and day. So that is why it is considered as warm climate, warm. And humidity is because we can see the relative humidity, which is 75%, okay, which is on the higher end. Usually the for a comfortable or for a thermal comfort, we consider humidity to be in between 30 to 70%. So it is slightly on the higher end of the comfort zone. So that is why it is considered as warm and humid climate. Now this climate has 60 to 90% of covered sky, majorly because of monsoons, clouds and this thing. And which is having a very good, it is partially reflected and partially scattered by the cloud blanket or high vapor content of the atmosphere. Because of the lot of moisture or air vapor that is present in the atmosphere, so solar radiation is partly reflected and partly absorbed by the atmosphere and also partly reaching the surface of Earth. Okay, so and wind velocity is typically low and calm periods are frequent, but strong winds can occur during the rain squalls or gusts of 30 to 30 meter per second that have been reported in this region. Okay, so that is mainly because of the tropical winds, that is because of maybe heating of Earth or because of the air movement from low pressure to high pressure areas. Okay. high pressure to low pressure areas. So again, coming to the vegetation part of the warm humid climate, because of lot of precipitation, because there is lot of humidity, so there is lot of vegetation, and this climate is very much favorable for most of the type of vegetation. So there is lot of vegetation found in this region, wherever there is landmass, and vegetation grows quickly due to very frequently rains and also high temperatures. So this climate basically is very much favorable for the growth of plant or even organic growth. So even a lot of microorganisms or organic substances are also, lot of organic substances are, growth happens in this region. Okay. Now special characteristics can be high humidity accelerates mold and algal growth, that is growth of algae, and rusting and rotting also happens very fast because of the climatic conditions, because of it is heat and also it is moist. Okay. So organic building materials tend to decay rapidly. Yes. Mosquitoes and other insects are abound, so they are also flourishing in this particular climate. The main this thing is threat is thunderstorms are accompanied by frequent air-to-air electrical discharges, so that that happens because of during the rain or monsoon, and also there are a lot of winds that is high spinned, so that can be considered as special characteristics for this particular region. Now the second type in warm humid is nothing but again island climate. So the warm humid island is in the equatorial belt. With trade winds zone belong to this climate. Typical examples can be Caribbean, Philippines, islands of group of Pacific Oceans. We'll try to see the elements of this climate. here we can see the temperature that is highest is around 32 degrees Celsius maximum, that is during summer, and 29 degrees is maximum during winter. And similarly, mean minimum temperature, that is the least temperature for during night, recorded during night, is 18 degrees Celsius, and highest is 24 degrees Celsius for any night, any for a cold night. And here we can see the humidity is slightly less during major part of the year, but again sometimes it goes up to 100% during monsoon or during rainy seasons. Okay. So the precipitation is slightly less as compared to the warm humid climate. So here it is around 1800 mm per annum. Okay. So sky conditions is normally clear or filled with white broken clouds of high brightness except during storms. Okay. Otherwise it is usually clear. So because it is clear, again there is lot of solar radiation that is entering into the atmosphere of this particular climate, and there is, it is having a very good solar radiation also. And wind velocity is also slightly higher as compared to the previous classification. Here it is around 6 to 7 meters per second. Okay. Now that is majorly throughout the year, so it is having a constant wind movement of 6 to 7 meters per second. Okay. So vegetation is slightly less luxuriant, as a lighter green color than in warm humid zones. It varies with rainfall. Sunlight reflected from the light colored coral, sand rock can be very bright. The soil is often dry with a fairly low water table. Okay, so the, compare it to the warm humid climate, here there is very slightly less vegetation. Okay, even the special characteristics are almost similar to that of warm humid climate, with cyclones, hurricanes and wind velocities from 45. Here the wind velocities are comparatively more, that is around 70 meter per second maximum. So that can cause a seasonal hazard. Okay. And the next classification, you can say hot, dry, desert climate. So as the name itself indicates, it is very hot and it is also dry. Okay. So these climates occur in two belts latitudes, that is 15 to 30 degree north and 15 to 30 degree south of the equator. Okay. Yeah, if you see the air temperature, it goes to a maximum of 49 degrees Celsius, that is highest recorded during summer. Sometimes it also goes to, it crosses more than 50 degrees Celsius in very few places, but most of the places you can say it can go up to 49 degrees Celsius, that is the mean maximum temperature. And the minimum temperature that is, that can be recorded is during winter, that can be up to 10 degrees to 18 degrees. Here we can see there is a lot of variation for the mean minimum and mean maximum temperature. Okay, so there is a lot of diurnal change, and also during every day during, let's say during summer, if the temperature of the day is around 43 to 49, then during night it is around 24 to 30 degrees Celsius. So there is a lot of difference between the maximum temperature recorded in day and night. Okay, similarly for winter climates also, there is more than 20 degrees Celsius that can be recorded for a some particular day and night. Okay, so that is for the maximum temperature and minimum temperature. Here the humidity falls on the lower end, that is around 10 to 55%, which is comparatively low. So that is why it is also considered as dry. Okay. In Köppen classification also, there was a similar mainly classification based on the temperature and also the precipitation. So similarly, even these classifications, the temperature, precipitation majorly contributes to the classification of climates. Okay. So this will, we can easily recognize, or we can easily classify based on these two elements, that is air temperature and humidity. Okay. Or you can say precipitation is also one of the factor which is resulting into the humidity. If there is more precipitation in an area, it results to the higher humidity. Okay. So that is why precipitation is one of the major element, either precipitation or humidity is considered as considered for the classification of different climate, and it is also characterized by the humidity and precipitation. Okay. Now these are also the factors that are resulting into the particular thermal comfort or comfort of a human beings or any other animals or any living beings. Okay, so or to the growth of any organism. So these are the factors that are responsible for accounting to the growth of particular organism, or leading to the growth of even vegetation or microorganisms also. Okay, so sky condition is normally clear. Okay, clouds are few due to the low humidity and of the airflow. Sky is usually dark blue with luminance of 1700 to 2500 candela per meter square. Okay, so solar radiation is again direct, because there is normally clear sky. So we can always see that sky condition and solar radiation are very much interrelated. Okay, wind velocity are winds are very hot and carrying dusty and dust and sand particles, is because of the dry climate. If it is moist, then there is if there is lot of moisture, that is humidity, or there is lot of precipitation, then we'll be not having the dust and sand. Okay, because it is very having very less precipitation and very less humidity, so that is why the air carries lot of dust and sand when it is moving. Okay, and vegetation is very sparse because of again less precipitation. Okay. And also, on the contrary, more temperature, it is very difficult for the, even for many plants to survive in this particular temperature, because there is also in this climate, and also there is lot of solar radiation. So that is why there is very, you can say, less growth of organisms or less vegetation in this particular area. Okay. So during certain months, dust storms and sand storms may be very frequent, mainly during summer months. Maybe before pre-monsoon months, and high daytime temperatures or rapid cooling at night, okay, may cause materials to crack and break up. So we can see there is a very large diurnal change. So we always also know that materials contract and expand based on the temperature. So because of this rapid contraction and expansion for a very longer period of time, or for a very shorter, that is for each day, there is contraction and expansion happening because of extreme temperature during day and very less temperature at night. So these materials might weather off. There are many, even many rocks might weather off, causing a lot of sand particles formation. Okay. So this can be considered as one of the special characteristics, and because and considering this, we have to use materials which will not or try to have techniques which is not getting weathered off or developing cracks inside buildings, walls, or any other structural members. Okay. So hot, dry maritime climate is again also a desert climate that occurs in the same latitude or same belt. Okay, so that is 15 degrees north to 30 degrees north. And 15 degrees to 30 degrees south. These are regarded as one of the most unfavorable climates because it is hot and dry, and it is also having slightly higher, you can say, humidity. Okay. So if you see the temperature, the maximum, that is 38 degrees Celsius, in cool season it remains between 21 to 26 degrees Celsius. That is during winters, it remains around 21 to 26 degrees Celsius. And minimum temperature, that is, you can see that is, it can be go to very less, that is 10 to 18 degrees Celsius. Okay, only during during winters. Okay, but whereas humidity remains slightly on the higher end, that is 50 to 90% of humidity is, and that is also for a shorter period. Okay, so usually it is 50 to 90%, that is very for a shorter period. But majority part of the year is it is having a hot and dry weather. Okay, but only for some part of the year it is having maritime, that is with higher humidity. Okay, and precipitation is also very low. So most of the moisture that is coming is from the sea or water bodies and these things. But there is no precipitation as such, which is why there is, you can say, very less vegetation also. Okay, so the sky condition is same as for hot, dry desert climates. Solar radiation is also very strong because of a lot of clear sky, and wind velocity is mostly local coastal winds caused by the unequal heating and cooling of the land and sea surfaces. Okay, so these areas are mainly next to let's say a water body, a sea or ocean. Okay, so because of the low pressure areas that are created in these areas, so there is again water which is in the water body, so that is again trying to maintain equilibrium. It is trying, there is lot of air that is moving from the sea to the towards the land. Okay, so there is lot of wind movement that is influenced in this area. Okay, so vegetation, we can see it is also very sparse. It is not very it is not more than dry grass. The ground and rocks are brown or red. It is dry and dusty throughout the year. Ground glare can be very intense. Okay. Special characteristics again are dust and sandstorms may occur. The salt laden atmosphere accelerates corrosion, which is very similar to the, let's say, warm humid climate. Okay, because the air is coming from the, let's say, sea or oceans, so they also carry a lot of salts. Okay, so that was also one of the reason for less vegetation. Okay, yeah. So coming to the third major classification, that is composite monsoon climates. So these, as I said, the composite climate can have extreme of warm humid climates, and also we can say it is having extreme of the hot dry climates. Okay, so there might be lot of changes in a particular, in one particular year. It can sometimes behave as warm humid or hot dry, or sometimes it can behave as a very hot dry climate. Okay, so it can behave as warm humid or hot dry. So that is why it is having a composition of two climatic classifications. So that is why the areas or geographical locations that are falling in these categories are considered as composite or monsoon climates. Okay, so we can see the elements of climate, of this particular climate, that is, we can see the temperature. The maximum for summer can go up to 43 degrees Celsius for a single, maybe highest recorded for a particular day. And the temperature can during winters can go as low as 4 degrees Celsius to 10 degrees Celsius during winters. Okay, so here we can see that it is having one of the highest temperature, and also 4 degrees, which is a very low temperature. Okay, for during winters. So, and also humidity, we can see it varies from 20 to 55%, and this 20 to 55% is for the period during monsoons and these things. But a major part of the year it remains dry. Okay, so here we can see there is a variations in this particular humidity also, and rainfall also varies from 500 to 1300 mm. Okay, so sometimes it might be for a year it might be having 500 mm of rainfall. For next alternate years it might be having more rainfall, that is maybe up to 1300 mm. Okay, so there might be a gradual change in this particular climate because of, again, global warming. It is said to have lot of rainfall because of a lot of ice is getting melted in the polar regions, and lot of that water from the polar ice caps is considered to be flowing through these areas, and it is reaching these tropical climates, and then there is lot of increased rainfall in these areas also. Okay, so there might be it is said to have more rainfall during monsoon, and this precipitation is actually varies. There is no you can say during monsoon it is very heavy rainfall, and during other part of the year so there is no precipitation at all. Okay, so that is why even there is extreme changes in, let's say, precipitations or humidity, and there is also extreme change in the temperatures. Okay, we can see the variation of the temperature, that is highest is 43 to 4 degrees Celsius, that is mean maximum to, if we compare to the mean minimum temperature. Okay, so that's why it is considered as composite monsoon climate. Okay, because here we can see that the monsoon that is having a very good rainfall also, sometimes it is having a very good rainfall, that is of 1300 mm, 1300 mm. Okay, sky is heavily overcast and dull during monsoon, and very clear dark blue color in dry season. So it is exhibiting both kind of sky conditions. It is having as similar to, let's say, warm humid and also hot dry. Okay, it is having a very cloudy during monsoon, and it is also having very clear during dry seasons. Okay, solar radiations varies accordingly based on the sky conditions. Okay, so it can have a very good solar radiation during, let's say, summer, and it may not be having it might be having less than, let's say, 30% or up to 30% of radiation during monsoon. Okay, wind velocity, monsoon winds are fairly strong and steady, hot and dusty during dry period. So both of the these things is experiencing lot of wind, that is during monsoon and also during dry seasons. So it experiences a very good wind velocity. Okay, so this is so vegetation is sparse. One maybe because of the more durational change. So many plants will not be able to survive this particular climatic change. And also there is a lot of, you can say there is lot of rainfall during monsoon, and there is no, absolutely no rainfall during, let's say, summer. So, so characteristics of a hotter region with brown and red barren ground changes rapidly and dramatically with the rain. So this plants will not be able to survive this sudden or dramatic change. The landscape becomes green and fertile with a few days, and plants grow quickly in the cooler period. Vegetation covers the ground but diminishes as the temperature rises. Okay, the soil is damp during rains but dries out quickly. Okay, there is a risk of soil erosion during monsoon in the dry season, and strong ground glare might be experienced. Okay, so these are the some of the vegetation, you can say vegetational behavior of vegetation. Even plants have evolved in this region so that they grow in this thing, and they also produce seeds for very shorter period, and then they die off. Okay, and this cycle happens every year, and even animals have engineered themselves to fit into this particular climatic zone. Okay, so special characteristics again can be seasonal changes in relative humidity cause rapid weakening of building materials. That was very similar to what you can say for a hot dry climate or for a this thing. So there is again a lot of change during the temperature, in terms of temperature, that might cause many cracks or weakening or weathering of rocks. Okay, and a lot of sandstorms may occur in this region. Termites are common. Occasional condensation patterns are observed in this particular climatic region. Okay, now last is again one of the category of the composite climate, that is tropical upland climate. So it is again a mountainous region with more than 900 to 1200 mm above the sea level. So because of its altitude, there is a small change in this climatic conditions, even though it is in the same climatic belt or zone. Okay, so there we can see the temperature is slightly less, and that is why it indicates it is having a tropical, it exhibits some behavior of tropical climates, that is little slightly warm, hot, and also having some humidity. And the upland indicates the it is slightly elevated from the as compared to from the other areas as compared with the mean sea level. Okay, it is slightly elevated with in comparison with the other areas. Okay, so here the temperature goes up to 30 degrees Celsius, that can be recorded for the maximum day during summer, and minimum can be up to 10 to 13 degrees Celsius, and some locations it may fall less than 4 degrees Celsius or up to 4 degrees Celsius during winter. Okay, so we can, so this behavior or this climate characteristics mainly happens because of the altitude of a particular geographical location. Okay, so humidity is also slightly higher, that is 45 to 99%, and we can say precipitation is less than 1000 mm, it does not increase more than 1000 mm. And sky condition is clear or partly cloudy to the extent of about 40% of sky cover. Okay, and solar radiation varies accordingly based on the sky condition. Okay, now wind velocity, so it is having a northeast and southeast southeasterlies, but may be drastically deflected by local topography. Okay, so wind velocity rarely exceeds 15 meter per second. Because of its altitude, it is so there might be some kind of blockage that might be happening because of the geography or the landforms. Okay, so we can see the vegetation is green, although not very luxuriant during wet season, but it may wither in dry season when the ground can turn brown or red. The soil may be damp in the rains and but dries quickly. So that is why it exhibits a similar properties as of composite climate. Okay, so special characteristics can be like heavy dew at night because of the altitude and because of lot of humidity. So the lot of condensation that happens more than this thing. So the dew formation is mainly observed through the major part of the year in this region. Okay, so strong radiation loss at night during the dry season, which may lead to the formation of radiation fog. Okay, So thunderstorms with a fair proportion of electric discharges and air to ground, and the hailstorms may also occur. Okay, so these can be considered as special characteristics. Now, so these are the classifications, or you can say characteristics of tropical climates. So, So here we can see the all the three, the major tropical climates, that is warm humid climate, hot dry climate, and composite climate. Okay, so these are the different recordings with comparison. So here we can see where warm humid climate, it is having a higher humidity, so this represents let's say humidity, and it is having humidity throughout the year, and it is also exhibiting some kind of so this is the maximum temperature and this is the mean temperature. But whereas for the hot dry desert temperature, we can see that it is very dry, it is very less humidity, only for during monsoon it exhibits a higher humidity and also higher. So this increase, this shows the higher temperature, mean maximum temperature for particular year, and this is mean minimum temperature for particular year. Okay, and coming to the last this thing, so that is nothing but composite climate. It exhibits both. Okay, we can see less humidity and also more humidity for two times in a year. The humidity increases and decreases, and it also experiences the highest temperature and the lowest temperature, what we can see as compared to. So these two qualities are, these two characteristics are combined to form, combined, or you can say it can be exhibited by composite or monsoon climate. Okay. So this was all about the characteristics of tropical climate. Thank you.